working rule for solving LPP linear programming problems by graphical method when feasible reason is bounded. Now what bounded means? I have drawn a graph, this is the bounded area. Okay, when we are having all the shaded part, all the lines which we are shading, now for example this one and this one, these are the three constants. Shading part for this constant is with red line, with this as a blue and with this as a green, and this becomes a bounded area. This is called a bounded area, feasible area or feasible bounded area. Okay, so how to solve it? Now let's move with some easy steps. Now step number one, draw the half planes of all the constants given in linear programming problem. What it means? Draw the half planes of all the constants given in the LPP. Means we have to draw first all the constants. Now step number two, make common area the feasible area. Common area means feasible area. Okay, make the common area by shading lines. Step number three, find the coordinates of all the vertices of convex region or the feasible region or area. Now we have to find the coordinates of all the vertices. For example, here we are having, we have to find the coordinates for, this is O, let this be P, Q, R and S. We have to find coordinates of all the vertices of a convex region or the feasible region. These are also called corner points. Okay. Now step four, find the value of objective function now what the objective function was, as we have done in the definition, z is equal to ax plus by at. Now find the value of the objective function, and this is the objective function z. Okay, objective function z is equal to ax plus by at each vertex of the convex region or the feasible region. Means now for coordinates for P, coordinates for Q, coordinates for R, coordinates for S, and this is the origin itself. Okay, so we have 1 2 3 4 5, and all the 5 pair of coordinates we are going to put here in place of X and Y. Okay, now the important thing, now what we are having, let A represents the maximum value let A represents the maximum value and B represents the minimum value of Z at the vertex of feasible region or area. Now we are having two terms. One is A, this is A, okay, and another is B. Now this is B. A represents the maximum value and B represents the minimum value of Z. Now what it means? This means that suppose we are having two points here in this. Now I have mentioned the characters with O, P, Q, R and S. Now suppose one of the vertices is A, which on putting the coordinates gives the maximum result, that is A, and other is B, which I have supposed it. Okay. So we are having A represents the maximum value and B represents the minimum value of Z. Now, step 5. Now, step 5 is for maximum value. For maximum value of Z is equal to AX plus BY. It is for the maximum value. Now, if Z is equal to A, now maximum value already we have supposed it as a. Now, if Z is equal to A at the vertex with M, N as the coordinates, M and N are the coordinates of the point A. Now, if Z is equal to A at the vertex M, N, then we say that the maximum value of Z is A when X is equal to M and Y is equal to N. Now, once again, when we are putting the coordinates of A, coordinates of A are M, N in the objective function Z and we are getting the maximum value, then we are saying maximum value of the objective function Z is at A. Okay. Now, step 6. For minimum value of Z is equal to AX plus BY. Now here we have what we have supposed. We have supposed that B represents the minimum value. B represents the minimum value. Okay. Now if Z is equal to B at the vertex C, D. Now coordinates of B are C, D. If Z is equal to B at the vertex C, D, then we say that the minimum value of Z is B when X is equal to C and Y is equal to D. Okay. So these were some basic steps how to locate maximum or minimum point in a given feasible area which is bounded. Okay, so we have done all these steps for the bounded region. Feasible region is bounded and this is bounded area. Okay, when we can make a circle on it, okay, that is called a bounded area.